Amen, amen, amen. Welcome, 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 everybody, Lakeland Christian Center, friends and family. Whoo, another Wednesday evening. We're here. God has blessed us, woke us up early this morning, and set us on our way in our right minds, amen, to know that we have got to get the word as often as possible. These are the times, the signs of the times and all that stuff the folks in the world are worried about and talking about. But we're good. We're safe. We're protected. God has a plan for his children. So we don't worry about the signs of the times. The closer we get to God, the better we are. We love it. We are not afraid of Jesus coming back. Amen. Because Jesus has been with us. We've been walking with him. So we know we're good to go. But nonetheless, I'd like to welcome you all to Lakeland Christian Center's midweek service. And of course, you know, my name is Pastor Derek T. Griffin, and I'm so excited to be here tonight. As usual, it's a plum pleasing pleasure to be with you all. I can thank Pastor Ryan and Pastor K for always just liberally saying, Derek, you have it. You got it. Make it happen, brother. Bring the word to the people. Bring the word to God's people. Edify them. Encourage them. Be the light that shines bright. And I just thank God for blessing me to be able to do this. He's been very good to me and my family and to our ministry and to all of us, actually, because of our faithfulness. And more importantly, because of his love, we are blessed. His love is forevermore. He loves his children. We are called the beloved. That means that God has placed his love on us, and I'm excited about it. I want to make a couple of announcements before I pray and bring in. I'm going to say this now, and I'm going to save it for later as well. And you might want to write this down. Some of this is important. Pastor Riley wanted me to let everyone know that he's going to start back with our family conference call on Saturday to, you know, to provide us with some very important church information that I'm not at liberty to share with you all here through this particular streaming. But on 8:30 this Saturday night. Okay, Cody, we're good. We're good. He's praising God, y'all. We got it, Cody. So nonetheless, the number, the conference call number is 678-460-8677. So put that number up there for me. I'll repeat it. And this is our family conference call for Lakeland. We do it every Saturday night, 8:30. So put it on your calendars, all the leaders and those members that want to hear the announcements. We got to get back to that because we got our anniversary coming up. We got spring cleaning. We got a lot of things we got to get in order and get ready to get blessed. But 678-460-8677. That is the conference number that we will dial on Saturday night at 8:30. Okay, so please make that an important moment for you all. Also, we have a fundraiser going on. The ladies of Lakeland, Pastor Riley wanted me to quote, he said, they're the aggressive ladies of Lakeland that are doing a fundraiser for our audiovisual department. We've got to raise some funds so we can get cameras and things that bring excellence to our ministry as far as streaming out to YouTube and things of that nature. You know, we've been challenged in that area with antiquated equipment. So we need to get up speed so we can get this word out to the world. It's called the Double Good Popcorn Virtual Fundraiser. And it's going to start April 3rd. I got in my notes here that you want to get involved. The text has been sent out to everyone, the deacons, and we might want to get Sister Ann to do it as well, to the broader group on the text in terms of the program and how it works. Let me see. I'll kind of give you a little bit. I don't want to waste too much time and get right to the word, but I do want to make sure we raise these funds. Before the fundraiser begins, it's going to start on April the 3rd at 3 o'clock p.m. and goes until April the 7th at 3 p.m. So we got 4 days to do this, everyone. Each of us will create a pop-up store and sell Double Good gourmet popcorn. You may have done this before with other organizations, sororities, fraternities, so forth and so on, that has been very successful because we all love popcorn, right? The popcorn is award-winning and really delicious. I agree. I believe I did buy some in one of those fundraisers from my friend Toot Sanders. Toot lives in Dallas, Texas, and he hit me up with it from Dallas. And so I got involved with that and ordered some of that good popcorn. But Double Good Popcorn, Gourmet Popcorn Fundraiser from April 3rd to April 7th. You want to download the Double Good app, and then you want to enter our Lakeland's event code. Now write this down. The event code is R as in Robert, P as in Paul, A as in Apple, J as in John, K as in Kite, Z as in zebra, in the app. And then you create your pop-up store. Okay? And we're raising those funds for our audiovisual. So there you go. Thank you, everybody. And you'll see it again. I just wanted to get it out there and make sure that we're ready to go. And then also I want to tell you, some of you did excellent last week. Wednesday, I asked you to share. Four of you shared. Wonderful. Because we didn't get nobody to share in the past. And we're getting this word out. So I'm going to ask you once again, we want to share this broadcast because we're trying to get more people to move towards our YouTube channel and start subscribing, right? We got to get subscribers, subscribers, subscribers. And you all, hey, Keisha, you all are actually very familiar with social media. It's the movement now. It's how we get the word out these days. Regular television is just not as effective as social media. And so, you know, we want to be good stewards of God's word. We know we're preaching the word. We're not doing anything outside of God's word. So why are we ashamed to get it out to folks? We shouldn't be. God is watching you. He knows if you're really purely sensitive and serious about what we're doing for him. So share, 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 share tonight. And then subscribe, subscribe, subscribe at YouTube. And we're going to have more progress and do more for the kingdom by doing that through social media. So thank you. I hope you do that tonight. Very good. I'm going to go ahead and pray. Oh, this is going to be good. Good word tonight, y'all. Whew, got another one. Here we go. Father God in heaven, thank you so much, Lord, for once again blessing us this tonight and allowing us to participate in your world, God. Tonight, again, I ask that you think through my mind and speak through my vocal cords as I minister to these, your sheep. God, I pray that and I ask that revelation knowledge will flow freely, uninterrupted by any demonic or satanic force. God, as always, none of me and all of you. I am your creation. I am your instrument. Use me, Lord. Use me mightily to your glory. Use me mightily unto your honor and your praise, God. I am all of yours. I've given every bit of my fabric of my body to you, and I'm so excited to be a part of your mission and your plan. And I thank you for tonight. I thank you for Lakewind Christian Center, its members, its friends, its families. I pray a blessing and an anointing on each and every one of them to be more so on fire for you than ever before in their lives. So tonight, God, thank you. That's what we say. Thank you. Because in thanksgiving, we get miraculous power that I'll share with them tonight. So thank you, Lord. We give you all the honor, all the glory, and all the praise. And these things we pray in Jesus' name. Amen. All right, here we go. Once again, I want to remind those of you who are getting ordained as ministers. It's coming, it's coming, it's coming, it's coming. I feel it coming. It's getting ready to happen. Graduation time. Take your notes, take your notes, take your notes. Write the scriptures down. Then more importantly, study those scriptures. Get it in your heart. Because you're going to need it when you start bringing the word from the pulpit. Amen. Here's the title of tonight's teaching. Thanking God, a prerequisite to godly intervention. Thanking God, a prerequisite to godly intervention. See, if you want God to intervene in your life, any area, if you want God to show up and show out in your life, we got to get gratitude right. Some of us are ungrateful. Some of us are not thanking God for even the little things. I've learned to thank God for everything. Boy, I'm breathing. Ooh, thank you, Lord. I can see you. Ooh, thank you, God. I can hear. Ooh, Lord. I don't take none of that for granted because I've got folks that's suffering from hearing right now that's in my family being challenged in their hearing. I've got individuals that was challenged in their sight, had to have operation, retina operation from bodily disease and so forth. There are a lot of things that folks are being challenged with in their bodies, their health, significant. And I thank God for keeping me healthy and strong, even when I'm making bad decisions, when I eat certain foods. Somehow the grace of God, the mercy of God has been there to protect me from having all kinds of calamities in my health. I just thank God that I get up every morning. I can put both feet on the ground. You hear me? There's a heart that God is looking for that has to be filled with thanksgiving. Because when we do that, I'm going to show you. I got the sauce. I got the plug. I'm getting ready to share with you all. It's the real deal. God showed me. And I understand now why so many wonderful things are beginning to happen into my life. And it's because of what I'm going to share with you tonight. Okay? Here we go. Thanksgiving to God is not just for the holiday. Let's just get that straight. We should not have to wait for Thanksgiving in November to all of a sudden start talking about the importance of thanking God. I want to clear that and kill that. That's tradition. We need to kill it. We need to understand that Thanksgiving is a daily requirement, a prerequisite for God to intervene in our lives on a daily basis. So tonight, I want you to really hear me clearly. Open up your spiritual ears so that you can hear this revelatory information that's going to change your life forever. I mean, this is it. I got the code, the cheat code, if you want to call it that, for this spiritual knowledge that's going to change your lives. And it starts with thanksgiving. There is a spiritual or divine process to directly experience God's awesome power of intervention in your life. It's proven. I found the proof. It's proven examples in the scriptures. I have proven examples in the scriptures to show you this. I'm going to show you the word of God. It says, tonight we will closely observe the process and procedures that our Father in heaven has made available to us with as his beloved. So this process, this blessing, this word I'm going to share with you is for us. It's for the ones who are loved by God, who are born again in their spirit, and they're operating in their faith, okay? Fully operating in faith, because God keeps a promise. God is not a liar, and God is liberal to give you wisdom to help you understand how things operate. See, we're suffering in Christianity because those Christians that have claimed Christ as their Lord and Savior still don't understand things that God is telling them, and they don't have the knowledge or the understanding to execute the word in such a way that you can get the results that God wants you to have. And so there are certain instructions you got to follow. You got to do it right. You know, we have that kind of attitude and behavior in the earth when it comes to jobs. When you're an employee and they train you, you have an employee manual, and you got to get trained on how to do a job if you're going to be a person that's customer service. Chick-fil-A is well known for their excellent training program. I used to work for them in security, and I had to go through that training, and I had to understand that campus and understand how they do things. And those of you who are familiar with Chick-fil-A, they don't play. As a matter of fact, they have one of the world-renowned training programs that people from all over the world, other corporations, send their employees to Chick-fil-A to get an understanding of how they do business, how they train their employees to be excellent when you pull up and they use the right words, thank you and my pleasure, and you know the deal, and you love it. And when you go somewhere else and they're not doing it, you get an attitude, right? Because there's a procedure, there's a process that brings profit. There's a process that brings favor. There's a process in the kingdom of God that will give you the power of God readily available to you to use to intervene in your life and make a difference like nobody's business. I got it tonight. The foundational scripture for tonight's service or tonight's training, teaching, is Psalm 89:23. Psalm 89:23. Watch this. It says, I will beat down his foes before his face and plague those who hate him. You say, how is that a foundational scripture for thanking God? Watch this. It's deep. I'll read it again. Psalm 89:23. He says, I will beat down his foes before his face and plague those who hate him. Here we go. David, King David, had a thanksgiving lifestyle and was grateful to God for everything he did for him. The Bible told us in Psalms 119:164 that David praised God, watch this, y'all, 7 times a day for his righteous judgments. David did that. Come on, y'all. He praised God, thanking him 7 times a day. Religiously, it was his lifestyle. He figured out the plug. He figured out, he's like, this is the code. This is what gets God to move on my behalf where I can defeat a giant. This is where God moves on my behalf when I can take down a whole army with very few men. This is the God that if I know this code, that when they take all the women and children and everything from my camp, I have no idea where they are. And all of a sudden, everybody's turning against me. The military, everybody's mad at me, my army guys, because I allowed, they blame me for everybody getting stolen and taken and kidnapped from the camp. And he said, I went away from them and thank God. Oh, and then he found everything. He went and found those folks, defeated the enemy, took all the spoils, women and children back to camp. David was a bad man. You hear me? But he knew the code of being grateful for everything God did for him. He thanked him. He wasn't ungrateful. And too often I notice, even in my own family, there are people who exhibit ungrateful spirits and attitudes. They are never satisfied. You give them one thing, they want more. They can never be thankful for the little bit that you give when you want to give them more. God's the same way. He said, be faithful in the least. Then I know I can trust you with the much. So if you can't be thankful for the little things that God is doing for you, how in the world do you think God's going to do greater things for you? You have to show appreciation. It's a grateful heart. I'm telling you, you capture this, your life is going to change. Now, because of David's thanksgiving lifestyle, God said to him, because of his thanksgiving lifestyle, God said to him, I will beat down his foes before his face. That's God talking. He said, you know what? Because David is such a thankful man, anybody that comes up against him, I'm going to beat him down. God said, when he said he's going to fight your battles for you, that's what he's going to beat him down. His word. He said, I'm going to beat him down. They better get off my boy. Isn't it wonderful to know that God's got your back like that? That nobody who thinks they're going to come up against you with hate, disdain, envy, jealousy, who tries to pull you down won't be able to do it because you know how to thank God for everything he got going on in your life. God said, I'll take care of them. Get them out the way. This is my boy right here. Go on, D. Do your thing, baby. Whoo! I love that. Let's move on. Whenever thanksgiving rises up to God, listen to me, y'all. He is stirred. God is stirred into action to perform a miracle on your behalf. How many of you would love a miracle? See, that's the thing where man can't figure it out, but God can. See, that's where the miraculous comes in. When you don't trust man no more because they done reached their end in terms of their wisdom on how to deal with your issues and your situations. I don't care if it's you're dealing with cancer, HIV, AIDS. I've heard so many miracles from people who testified about how they got over. But understand something. That got over. God got you over because somewhere in the process, the procedures of the kingdom, you had a thankful heart. You were grateful and thankful for everything God was doing for you, even in your challenge, even in your issue. You didn't murmur and you didn't complain because that's what blocks the blessing. Murmuring and complaining, giving excuses and being ungrateful. My mama used to call me an ungrateful goat. Anytime she would give me something and I come back asking for more and then be mad because she won't give me no more, she said, you ungrateful goat, you. I said, Lord have mercy. And I realized she wasn't giving me nothing else after that. Man, I cut my blessing off by being what? Ungrateful. An ungrateful heart leads to poverty. An ungrateful heart leads to not being protected by the anointing of God. The ungrateful heart will lead you into lack. An ungrateful heart will keep you in bondage to people. An ungrateful heart is what brings pity on you. But being thankful to God, a thankful heart for what he does through people that he sends to you. I praise God for Pastor Rodney. Y'all don't understand something. Understand something. I now understand why God sent Pastor Rodney to me. I didn't understand before. I had no clue. I was like, why are you sending this man to me? Why is he talking to me? I didn't even know Pastor Riley when he came to me. I had no clue. But he sent him to me. He was sent. So I was thankful to have a man like Pastor Riley be sent to my life at the time of my trial and challenge. He sent that man of God. And I was thankful for that. And here I am today. God is a blessing like nobody's business when you start acting like you care about everything he does for you. Let's keep going. Let's keep moving. Whenever thanksgiving rises up to God, he is stirred into action to perform a miracle. Watch this. You want to be a thanksgiver. You want to be a thanksgiver because thanksgiving releases enormous power of God to do wonders in your life. So in order to be in a thanksgiving type of situation, you have to be a thanksgiver because God is a giver. So when we operate in the spirit of God, I got the plug. Y'all better hear me. This is the process. Don't just be one that is a receiver only because God says it's better to what? Give than to what? Receive. Why? Because in being a thanksgiver, you open up miraculous power in your life. See, you want miraculous power. You want supernatural power. You want divine power because that will separate you from the normal person who ain't got what you're getting tonight. See, God's giving me revelation knowledge to share with his people, not to keep to myself. It's not just for me. It's for all of you. I've got witnesses right now that I can share with you to give you my testimony in terms of what God has been doing in my life since I learned the plug about being a Thanksgiver. Whoo, it's powerful. But y'all got to get it too, and then you got to tell somebody, and they tell somebody, and then our kingdom of God is getting fortified with a bunch of Thanksgivers who are operating in supernatural power. I'm going to keep this moving. Now, listen to this. Gratitude is a spiritual force that empowers you to scale to higher heights. Gratitude. Come on now. Listen to me. It's a spiritual force because it's untouchable. You can't touch gratitude. It's intangible. It's in the spirit. It makes the universe God created respond to a grateful heart. Woo, Lord have mercy. When you are a grateful, thankful Christian, powerful supernatural forces from heaven are unleashed that cause things to work for you the way they should. See, stop being a selfish, a spoiled Christian who's just out of order, thinking that your pity is moving the hand of God. Your self-pity does not move the hand of God. It blocks the miraculous from happening in your life. It's going to make you get disgusted with God because you're still trying to use flesh to move him. You're using your thinking, your plan, your way to get God to move on your behalf when God said, no, you got to thank me. Have a grateful heart for what I've already done for you. Why are you over here upset because you didn't get this and get that and the other when you didn't even thank me the last time I got you over last week when you were dealing with some challenges and you didn't even recognize it was God? You took it and act like it was you. It wasn't you. It wasn't you. It was God on working on behalf of you. That's the key. Learn to thank God. Be grateful, right? Gratitude. Right. Watch this. Every time you give genuine thanksgiving, and you know what genuine means, sincere, real thanksgiving unto God, fresh oil for fresh impact comes to you. You never run dry. Watch this. You'll never run dry in blessings with constant daily thanksgiving unto God. Man, let me tell you, that's a powerful thing. I get everyone, thank you, Lord. Thank you for my peace, Lord. Thank you for this day. Thank you for waking me up. Thank you, Lord, for the business, the relationships, things that haven't happened yet, I receive it. And I thank you for it right now in advance, God, for the favor, for the favor and the doors that you will open, God, right now, because I believe your word. I trust you with my life. I'm all yours, God. I thank you for the deliverance of my children's souls. I thank you for my marriage, God, to make it more powerful and mighty and great, God. I'm not ashamed of marriage. I want it to be awesome, God, the way you want it to be. I thank you for it right now. I'm telling you, learn to thank God in advance. And now you really operating in something powerful. You ain't got to wait for him to give it to you. You act like it's already done. Thank you for my health and strength. Thank you for my breakthrough. Thank you, Lord. Woo, before I even get there, because I already know God's got it. Here we go. I'm going to prove to you about this oil thing because David talks about that. So every time you give genuine thanksgiving, fresh oil for fresh impact will come on you, which is the anointing. You never run dry with the anointing. You're going to always have constant blessings, constant thanksgiving. Watch this. Go to Psalm 89, 20 through 24. I'm going to read the King James Version. It goes like this. That's Psalm 89, 20 through 24. It goes like this. He says, God says, I have found David, my servant. With my holy oil have I anointed him. Because David lived a Thanksgiving lifestyle where he was praising and thanking God seven times a day. That was a part of his life. In other words, like you eat breakfast in the morning, brush your teeth, take a shower. You need to add to that, thanking God. Every morning, I got the word going. Every morning, I find a word. Every morning I get up, I got to hear the word. It's like I got to hear from God every morning. Not sometimes when I feel like it. It's not about my feelings. It's about a regimented lifestyle that when I'm getting ready for work, every day, I gotta have the word in my ear. I gotta have a word fresh from God to anoint me and get me ready for what it is he's got me out here doing. It's just a part of my life. It doesn't matter. I'm telling you, it's the most powerful. And the more you do it, the better you'll get at it. It becomes a habit. And then God says, I got him. I got him. That's what you want. You want to hear God say, I got you. Now let's go. Stop running from God. Lock in. Get in that word and start letting that word just touch you every day. Then your mouth will start saying those things you're hearing from God. And then you'll start seeing those things you're saying. And then the thanks comes in. Boy, you'll be like, ooh, thank you, Lord. Did I do that? Did that pop? And you start figuring it out like David did. David had to figure it out. He didn't just know that. He figured it out. When he beat the bear, he's like, how did I beat that bear? Then he had to fight a lion. Boom, I beat the lion. What? I'm a bad man. Just a little boy. But he had a relationship with God, and God had his back. Does God have your back? Y'all don't hear me. But he said, I have found David my servant with my holy oil. I have anointed him. He says, with whom my hand, watch this, God says, with whom, David, my hand, God's hand, shall what? Shall be established. That means locked in. Established means he ain't taking it away. No matter what happens in David's life, God says, my hand is established on him because he had a lifestyle of thanksgiving. Watch this. He said, my arm also shall strengthen him. So when David hits his limitation, God says, I'm going to kick it in because I've established, I put my hand on him, that he's going to have supernatural power to do greater things because my arm, God said, my arm is supernatural. So David can only do so much in the natural, but because he's a thanksgiving type of dude, I'm going to put my power on him, and it's going to be an extension of me, which now he's in the supernatural. That's unbelievable. That's available to us. Y'all got to hear me tonight. The enemy shall not, watch this. He said, because I got this going on with David, because he's thankful, he thanks me, he appreciates me, his God. He shows me appreciation. He's not taking God for granted. He's sincere about every move he makes and understands everything God is doing for him. He recognizes God in every aspect of his life. God said, what? The enemy shall not exact anything upon him, nor the son of wickedness. Who is the son of wickedness? Y'all better read this word. Y'all better get this, man. Ladies, look at me. Listen to me. Look at that. He said, the enemy shall not exact upon him, nor the son of wickedness afflict him. The devil himself, God said, ain't gonna touch David. Thankfulness keeps the devil away. Y'all hear me? A thankful heart, God said, I got to hold that devil back because I got one. God said, I got one he can't touch. Whoo, that's deep. Some of y'all dealing with the devil right now, let me tell you why. Because you ain't thankful. You're ungrateful. You don't praise your God. You don't honor your God like you should. It's time to get it right. It's time to give God his just due. He deserves it. Yes, he does. Trust me. Think about the times he saved your puny, itty bitty thinking, bad mistake making, sinful heart having self. And God still said, I got you. I love you. Come on in, bro. Whoo, man. And he says in verse 23, not only did he say, the enemy won't be able to touch him, that Satan won't be able to touch him, he went on to say, and I will beat down his foes before his face and plague them that hate him. And then God goes on to say, but my faithfulness and my mercy shall be with him, and in my name shall his horn be exalted. Come on. Thankful heart. I told you I was going to tell you the truth tonight. I got the sauce, baby. I got how you can get out of that bondage you got going on, out of that addiction, out of that issue with your health, out of that issue in your bad relationship, out of that issue on that bad job that you don't like and you know you need to go somewhere and get blessed and take your talents where somebody's going to appreciate you, then appreciate your God. That's what you need to do. You need to thank God. When you thank God, you glorify his name. Go to Psalm 50 and 23. I'm going to show you. It's in the NIV version. Ah, Lord. Here we go. Psalm 50, 23, NIV. He says, those who sacrifice thank offerings, those who sacrifice thank offerings honor me. It's called a sacrifice of praise. Y'all remember that? Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I'm giving to you a sacrifice of praise. Unto who? God. Sacrificial honor in your gift giving. Seed. Sacrifice. Yeah, you ain't got it. It's a sacrifice when you give it, but I give it unto the Lord. Look what he says here. Those who sacrifice thank offerings honor me, and to the blameless I will show my salvation. Meaning I'll be there for you whenever you need me to get you out of the situations that you get yourself caught up in. I'll give you a way of escape because you've given me an honor by sacrificing praise, your gifts, your first fruit, all of that. I got you. It's the connector. Sacrifice is the connector that honors you. And it connects you to the blessings of God. Thanksgiving has the power to bring encouragement to the testifier and helps to build more confidence in God. Go to Lamentations 3, 22 and 23. I'm going to read the NIV version there. It says, because of the Lord's great love. Watch this. Watch this. Because of the Lord's great love, we are not consumed. For his compassion never fail. His compassions, plural, never fail. They are new every morning. Great is your faithfulness, God. That's David telling you. Because he had a relationship of thanksgiving. I'm in this situation. It's good to go. God, your compassion is awesome. You've had compassion. You helped me through this. You helped me through that. You got me through this. You got me through that. Thank you, Lord. Thank you so much. Keep it moving. David was encouraged when he was testifying to Saul about how he fought the lion and the bear. He said Goliath would not be a problem. Come on now. Thanksgiving brings edification to the hearers. It builds up the faith of others. Go to Romans 10 and 7 where it says, watch this, faith cometh by hearing and hearing by the word of God. God is not a respecter of persons, y'all. So what he did for David, he'll do for us. What God did for someone else, he can do for others. So it's available to us if it was available to David. Thanksgiving qualifies you for another act of favor from God. Testimony commits God to do more. Your testimony commits God to do more for you because you're giving him the glory and you're giving him the credit for your blessings. You're not trying to pump your chest out and act like you the smart one and act like you got it going on, like you better than everybody else and you smarter than everybody else. And you just so, God, I did that for you. I made you. So how are you going to take credit for anything you're doing and then eliminate me? If I'm in you, I made you, I'm on you, then it's all God. So the real excitement is I got God on my side. I'm good to go. I got to give God the glory. He on my side. It ain't me. I couldn't halfway do what he's doing for me right now. I mean, I can't even do an inch of what he's doing for me right now. I just watch what he's doing. I'm on the journey of life and just observing all the things God is doing. And I'm like, wow, this is deep. Lord, ooh, where'd that come from? Ooh, Lord, really? Ooh, thank you, Jesus. I mean, what? Unexpected income. What? I mean, relationships, partnerships, all kinds of favor. Folks calling me out of nowhere. I got something for you. Like, what? I mean, it's crazy what's going on right now. And I mean that in a good way. But I'm telling you, it's because I give him all the glory. I'm not ashamed of the gospel. I'm not ashamed to tell you God is on my side. I love that fact that I got Almighty God on my side. You need to be saying the same thing. You need to have the same relationship. Because if David got it, it's available to you and I as well. Moving on. David was encouraged when he was testifying to Saul, as I said. Thanksgiving brings edification to the hearers, right? We got faith coming by hearing. Thanksgiving qualifies you for another act of favor from God. Testimony commits God to do more. Go to Proverbs 3 and 9. 3, 9, and 10. Watch this. NIV, Proverbs 3, 9, and 10. He says, honor the Lord. Watch this, everybody. Listen to this. Don't take this one for granted. It says, honor the Lord with your wealth, with the first fruits of all your crops. Then your barns will be filled to overflowing, and your vats will brim over with new wine. It propels the testifier to a greater height. God said, honor him. Honor him with your wealth that he gave you. But he said, it's yours because I gave it to you. He said, your wealth that I gave you, honor with it. Give it, just give some back. Show me you recognize that I gave it to you. By sacrificing, by giving some of it back. It's all good. Because there's more where that came from. Did you know that? Did you know that God is the ultimate source? He's unlimited. There's no relinquishing the source of God. So if you give up a little bit, he'll bring it back tenfold. If you're giving it up with the right thankful heart. Thank God for the fact you got something to give back. Real talk. Thank God you got something that he gave you to give back in the first place. Because the man, if he gave it to you, he can give it to you again. He says he's a giver. Thanksgivers, that's what we need to be. Woo, boy. Psalm 18:1-3. Psalm 18:1-3, the NIV says, I love you, Lord, my strength. The Lord is my rock, my fortress. And my deliverer, my God is my rock in whom I take refuge, my shield and the horn of my salvation, my stronghold. I call to the Lord who is worthy of praise, and I have been saved from my enemies. I mean, come on now. If you got God who's for you, like he said, who can be against you? Nobody. No thing, no other spirit. No other demonic spirit or entity. Nothing. No, what is it? Prejudiced or racist or upside down government. None of that stuff. When God is on your side, none of that stuff can stop you. It is what it is. He's your rock and he's your salvation. He's got you. Because you have a thankful heart. Let's keep going. Strength and courage is released when you thank God. Thanksgiving brings incredible multiplication. Y'all ready for this? Watch this. Thanksgiving brings incredible multiplication. It is one thing to have addition, but it's a greater thing to have, watch this, multiplication, right? John 6:5-13. Watch the miraculous power of having thanksgiving in your heart. Watch this. John 6:5-13. That's where the 5 loaves of bread and 2 fishes, the 2-piece fish dinner, multiplied in the hands of Jesus. Watch this. After he gave thanks to God. What? There's a process and a procedure. He thanked God first before it was what? Multiplied. It hadn't multiplied until he gave thanks to God. So if you want multiplication, thank God with the little that you have. Thank you, God, for my $5 in my bank account. And I mean that. that I got a bank account that's open and not closed for insufficient funds. I thank you, Lord, for this $5. And I pray that you multiply this, Lord, multiply it in the name of Jesus. Woo! Watch what happens. Watch what happens. So if you see, it says the 5 loaves of bread and 2 fishes multiplied in the hands of Jesus after he gave thanks to God, 5,000 people were fed. And there were about 12,000 baskets left over. Go to John 6, 11, 13 to see the story. But nothing is little in the hands of a thanksgiver, because God will cause an increase. Nothing, repeat, is little in the hands of a thanksgiver, because God will cause an increase. Thanksgiving turns healing to wholeness. So if you want to be made whole in your body from a sickness, go to Luke 17, 11 through 19. And in there, he talks about the lepers, right? There were 10 lepers cried out to Jesus, asking for mercy, and he healed them. But only one out of the 10 returned to thank him. Jesus said to him in verse 19, arise, go thy way. Thy faith hath made thee whole. Wholeness is complete health. As you praise and thank God, may you experience his wholeness in Jesus' name. Thanksgiving brings incredible restoration. In John 11 and 41, Jesus gave thanks and Lazarus rose from the dead. As you give thanks, every opportunity that was dead in your life will be restored in Jesus' name. Thanksgiving brings total deliverance from all your troubles. Psalm 50, 14 through 15. Offer unto God thanksgiving and pay thy vows unto the Most High, and call upon me in the day of trouble, and I will deliver thee, and thou shalt glorify me. That works, y'all. I've already experienced that. I just shared it with my wife today. I said, let me show you what God did to me today. Let me show you what God did for me today. Because I heard from him. I did what he told me to do. I was dealing with a challenge. I prayed about it. I said, I want this challenge gone, God, because it's getting on my last, I'm going to say it, my last nerve. I'm tired of that. That's got to go. Help me, Lord. Help me. Something came up. Perfect. He gave me the vision. He said, do it this way. Bop, 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 bop. I did it that way. Bop, 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 bop. And sure enough, boom, manifestation. That thing gone. God took care of it. But then behind taking care of that, guess what he did? He brought in more to replace what I had to give up. Good God, I said, look at it. God, what? I said, baby, that's God. Look right here. I'm telling you. Thank you, Lord. It works, y'all. I'm telling you. It's like, whew, it gives me chills when I think about that this thing is so alive and so real. I'm not just putting on for y'all. I'm telling you, I got so many miracles happening in my life, testimony I can share with you. That's just like, it's just like, wow. And I can't wait to just share this kind of knowledge to know that practicing this, living this, he gets it done. And you got to get excited about it. Because you know, all of y'all upset about the Falcons and all that foolishness. All of y'all get excited about all that. Look, take that same energy and give it to God. And watch what he'll do in your life. Watch this. So he said, I will deliver thee and thou shalt glorify me. Thanksgiving provokes. Watch this. Thanksgiving provokes the blessings of God upon your life. Thanksgiving provokes the blessings of God upon your life. In 2 Chronicles 1, 6 through 15, Solomon, ooh, we know about him, don't we? Solomon offered unto God 1,000 burnt offerings and went to bed. He got divine visitation. He got a blank check from God. He got divine overflow, more than he asked for. And he got divine overwhelming prosperity. Silver became like stones. Look at verse 11 when you read that. God told Solomon, you did not ask for riches, wealth, honor, and long life. God added all these blessings as extra to Solomon. He made a sacrifice, thanking God for what he had. He said, I just need wisdom, Lord. God said he was sincere about that too. He wasn't trying to play God. He wasn't trying to freak him out. And he said, you know what? God was so pleased with that response. He gave Solomon everything. Goodness gracious. So Thanksgiving brings down the glory of God. In 2 Chronicles 5, 13 through 14, when high praises and thanksgiving was rendered to God, his glory filled his house and the priest could not stand. Sickness, disease, sorrow, and demons cannot stand as you give God thanks in Jesus' name. When was the last time you just, in your own house, nobody watching, just yelled, thank you, and broke down, hit your knees, thank you, Lord. God, thank you so much, Jesus. I almost wrecked my car one day. I was in so much thankful. Man, I had to catch myself before I hit somebody. I was in such joy and thanking God for what he did for me. How he just continues to show out for me. And I'm not bragging. Please, I'm giving God the glory. I'm letting you know what I'm sharing with you. I've applied the principles, the process, and the procedures. Because he said, test me and see. And see that I'm good, Derek. Go on and do it, man. Don't just talk about it, but be about it. And too many of us in the church are talking about it, but we're not being about it. And therefore, we're not getting the results that God said you should get. Just use simple logic. You don't have to be so spiritually deep to get something that God is giving to you in simple language. It's about your attitude of gratitude, ladies and gentlemen. It really is. You know, it's just that we've been taught by this world and society to just be ungrateful and never be satisfied because they're always giving you something else to look. The lust of the eyes and the lust of the flesh, the Bible talks about. Because you're just continually chasing the egg rather than the goose. See, we got it backwards. The world teaches you to want the things, not the source of the things. That's why we're big consumers and not what? Producers. Because we don't understand the principles of God. If you desire to be a producer, you'll always have the things that you produce. Hello. So rather than just saying, I want this car, buy stock in the people that make the car. Now you're an owner of that business. You're a producer. That's why people who invest in stock get rich. Because they understand ownership is more important than driving that which somebody else is paying for. Woo! Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Wake them up, Lord. Wake them up. Because they're sleeping on you, Lord. Everybody's sleeping on you, Lord. I'm telling you, he said, those that are slothful, sleeping on God's word, ain't gonna get nothing. Here we go. Oh, man, I'm feeling good. Thanksgiving precedes a new era. Y'all ready? Thanksgiving precedes a new era, a new beginning. How many of us are tired of the old, same old stuff, dealing with the same old problems, dealing with the same old people that ain't changing? They still talking about the same stuff since 1985. I know some folk like that, still talking about back when, back then, this, that. Same old, same old. Remember that term? Same old, same old. You want some new stuff? Watch this. New era, new beginning. I got the sauce. If you want a new era of miracles, signs and wonders, then begin with thanksgiving, right? Go to Luke 22, 19 through 20, the NIV version, and it says, and he took the bread, gave thanks, and broke it. Jesus gave thanks. He took the bread. It's the process, procedure. Gave thanks and broke it. And he said, and he gave it to them, saying, this is my body given for you. Do this in remembrance of me. Watch this. Y'all know what this is. Watch this. In the same way, this is verse 20, after the supper, he took the cup, saying, this cup is the new covenant, in the same way, meaning he thanked. This cup is the what? The new covenant. new covenant. What about the old? What's the old? If it's new, there must have been an old. There was an old agreement between man and God. It's all in the Old Testament. Jesus brought in the new. You want a new beginning, you got to get a renewed mind on what's being said today, according to Jesus. This cup is the new covenant in my blood, which is poured out for you. Not dripped out, poured out for us. A new covenant is in the blood of Jesus. Receiving Jesus' blood in a sacramental process of receiving Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior and pleading the blood for a new beginning in my life. You want to plead the blood of Jesus over your life for a newness. Thanking him in advance for the new life, the new way, the new world that you get ready to experience in the kingdom of God. The power is supernatural. Thank him for it and watch what happens. He made it available to us. Today's nugget, Thanksgiving precedes a new era. And I want you to remember the following. Got 5 minutes. Grumbling or complaining while waiting stops this process. Stop that. Don't grumble. Don't complain about what you're going through. Stay thankful till you get to the other side. Number two, it's inclusive of thanksgiving and praise. This cheat code I'm talking about. So y'all need to start praising God. Not necessarily y'all hear praise, y'all think singing. God almighty. Yeah, singing is an element of praise. When I praise my child, I don't sing. I say, son, you did really good today. I'm so proud of you. I'm going to say positive encouragement. You know what? You keep doing that thing, brother. You're doing all right. I really like the way you handled that today, Blake. You know, that makes him feel wonderful. He got a praise from his God. Praise God. God, you are a wonderful God. You are just so awesome. Lord, I really appreciate it. Sometimes you can break out in singing because you feel like singing about it, but you can talk about it in praise. God, thank you and praise him and tell him how wonderful he is. He soaks it all up, especially when it's genuine and sincere and you're really telling him how you feel. Come on now. Powerful examples of who worked that process as well was Abraham, who was the father of faith, who fainted not at the enormity of the promise, but continually praised and thanked God for it before he even saw it or experienced it. Y'all know what I'm talking about. Number three, thanksgiving provokes the blessings of God over your life. You want blessings? Start thanking God. You want to have a heart that is continually filled, continually, daily, every day, lifestyle. That's how you live. That's how you talk. That's how you are. It is a part of who you are and who you will be. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, even for the good and the bad. Hallelujah. Because the no's from God sets you up for the big yes that you ain't seen yet. So sometimes God did it to me this past weekend. He gave me a no. But I was still like, thank you, Lord. I know maybe that because that ain't happening. That means you got something else for me. He gave me a no. It was like, it wasn't happening. I was like, man, that's okay. That's okay. Because I told my wife, I'm going to get what God said I'm going to get today. I'm going to get it today. Thank you, God. And all of a sudden, the Lord started guiding my steps. It was the most amazing journey. If I could just tell you the journey that I went through to get to this spot. And when I got there, Lord, have mercy. God said, there it is. I told you no to that because I wanted you to have that. I said, good God, Lord Jesus. Whoo, man. God is good, y'all. God's good. I'm telling you, he's a mighty God. I just want to thank you all for tonight. Tonight has been wonderful. I really hope you got this message. Praise God. I want to make sure that, you know, this is not, you know, entertainment at the Apollo. I'm very animated. It's my personality, but that's God made me that kind of guy. I'm a happy dude like that. And so I just love it so much. It's exciting for me to share the goodness of God with his people. But I do want you to know this is real. Take this word for real. It works, y'all. It's a good word. It's a good word. God's going to back it up. I tested it. I was the test dummy, right? I was the, what do they call it? The gerbil in the wheel. You know, they test you and everything. They used me in the lab. God used me in the lab. and came out so I could come and tell you all, thank God, praise him every day. Every day, make it your lifestyle. You will see God doing some mighty things in your life. I'm telling you, it's there. It's real. It's alive. It's the best. If you need to receive Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior, salvation is very important. It's a part of getting into the kingdom. You got to believe on Jesus, as we all know. And I'm going to make this very quick because this is important. I'm going to read some announcements before you go. But Romans 10 and 9, right? We already know that if thou shalt confess with thy mouth and believe in thy heart that Jesus Christ had died and was raised from the dead. He came in for 3 days. And that you now receive him as your Lord and Savior. But you got to believe that, right? And you got to believe it with your heart. Man believing him with the mouth, he confesses that Jesus Christ is Lord. So you got to say it in front of people. You got to be a witness of God's presence in your life. Don't be afraid to talk about God, believing that Jesus did come from the dead. A lot of people don't want to believe that some man could come back from the dead. They don't believe it. I believe it. I believe God, if he can give you life, and you die, he can give you life again. I have no doubt in my mind by me living that I know if I die, God, if he wants me to come back up out of that grave, I'm coming back up out of that grave. It is what it is because God is all powerful. He's the architect, the manufacturer, the provider, the producer. He's all in all of life and the design of life and the universe that we exist in today. And he's sovereign. So if he wants you to come back, you coming back. It is what it is. So I got it. I get it. And I thank God for having that. And I want you to have it. Praise God. Amen. You make that confession. Here's the time to give. Remember, thanksgivers. I just told you, God said, give your wealth, give a portion, not all of it, but give a portion to honor him of what he's already given you. And then guess what? It opens you up for multiplicity, multiplication. God wants you to have increase. God is a God of increase, right? We live in an increased world. You see trees, grass, stars, it's in the multitude. He's in the multitude. He's not a little God, although he has a small voice, right? But he's big in terms of what he does for us, the beloved. So give as the unction, as the Spirit of God tells you to give, right? Give, just give. Tithe, offerings, whatever, above the offering, above the tithe, just give. Knowing that God sees a sincere giver, he's going to come back and give you more. I'm telling you what I know. We have a fundraiser. As I told you before, I'm going to remind you of the popcorn fundraiser. The ladies, the aggressive ladies, as Pastor Riley calls them, have started this popcorn program. Make sure you get involved. It starts April 3rd. More information will be coming forth. Also, Saturday night, 678-460-8677, 678-460-8677. 8677 is our conference number at 8:30 this Saturday night to get up-to-date information. Leaders and those who are interested in being plugged in and knowing what's going on and to participate in what it is Pastor Riley needs us to do to get ready for the increase, amen, of our church. Please participate. Put it on your calendars. And lastly, God bless you. Thank you. Thank you for joining. Have a good night. God bless.